Hey guys, it's Allie with Allie Answers. I hope that you're having a fantastic day. It is raining really hard where I am, so I hope there's no background noise bothering you, and please excuse the cooler. I didn't have anywhere else to put it, so sorry. What are the first clues that someone that you love might have dementia? So let's talk about it. First of all, the very first sign of dementia, normally, believe it or not, is falls. That's right. And the reason that is because the way that our brain interprets space relations is changed very early on in the dementia process. A lot of times when you have brain damage, you are unable to process properly how that space relation is to your body. So when someone is trying to sit on the toilet, or they're trying to sit down in their chair, or they're navigating a hallway, then they are misjudging the space. And a lot of times that will cause falls. You may have noticed on your loved one some bruises that don't seem appropriate, and they may be from falls. Be aware that a lot of seniors will hide falls. They will not tell you. So if you haven't yet, if your loved one is not living with you, they are living on their own, make sure that you befriend their friends and that you befriend their neighbors, because you need spies. If you're like a lot of people, your loved one may share what's really going on with their closest friends and with their neighbors so that they can hide it from you. So if you talk to them, make sure that they know that you are aware and that you want to be in the loop. Another indicator and early sign of dementia is problems with money. So in my experience, people will often complain that they had problems with their computer, that their phone's not working, that the ATM wouldn't work, that something went wrong with their bank account. But really, when you investigate, you find out that they are mishandling their money and or are not able to use those items anymore. Maybe the computer is too complicated, maybe the phone app changed somewhat and they're not able to keep up with it. If you are not on accounts with your loved one, then you really want to pay attention to the complaints that they might have about their account. If they tell you, for example, that money is missing from their account or that they're having trouble logging in, this is a great window and opportunity for you to invite yourself in, say, listen, why don't I get on the account with you? And then if you have trouble logging in, I can help you, because otherwise I'm not able to help. That way you'll be more likely to see if your loved one is paying bills a couple times, or most often they don't pay them at all. It will help you make sure that they have air conditioning in the hottest months and heat in the coldest months, but it will also be an indication to you that there is a problem. Missing appointments is another indication of dementia. We all forget things, and this past year or two has been terrible. A lot of us are having more problems remembering what we need to be doing. So don't be too hard on yourself if that's the case for you, or even for your loved one. However, regularly missing appointments is an indication of early dementia. If you've not already, please make sure that your loved one signs a HIPAA release at the physician's office. Most physicians will not share information with you unless you have a HIPAA release. As I'm sure you know, HIPAA is just designed to protect your loved one and protect their personal information. But if you are responsible for them, or you're going to be responsible for them as things progress, you need to know what's going on. Even if your loved one has not signed the HIPAA release yet, you can still call the office and ask that you be told if they miss any appointments. Some doctor's offices will give you a call if there's a problem, and some will not, but it's always worth a shot. If you're local, one of the ways to see if there is a problem is to take a look at their personal surroundings. If, for example, they used to be a very neat and clean and organized person, and you're starting to see clutter build up, or a dirty bathroom where they never before had that, that can be an indication that you are starting to see some brain damage or dementia. If you're starting to see messes where there never were any before, that is an indication. Something that you'll want to check if you're local is the expiration dates on their food. If you see that they have a bunch of food and a lot of it is expired, first of all, obviously help them clean out their pantry or clean out their refrigerator. But secondly, keep an eye on this. I've heard many stories where the first indication that there was a problem with someone's loved one was that they were eating expired food and got sick. The other side of the spectrum is not eating enough. My grandmother admitted to me that it was easier not to heat up soup or make a sandwich because it just made a mess. She would just rather not eat. That was one of the signs of dementia. She actually got frustrated with all the steps that were involved in making that sandwich or making that soup. And so, yes, it was exhausting to have to make a meal, and she was declining in health, but also it was more confusing and frustrating for her to complete those tasks. Make sure that you have a backup plan ready, whether it's having cooked meals delivered or whether it is delivering meals yourself to them. Another thing that happens often is unintentional weight loss or weight gain. Sometimes when people have dementia, they are unable to make wise choices when it comes to food, and they may be eating boxes and boxes and boxes of Little Debbie's and cartons of ice cream instead of healthy food. So they may be exhibiting weight gain or being unhealthy. Again, it's important to take a look at the cabinet and see what they're eating. An obvious sign of early dementia is getting lost. If they go to their favorite place and they can't get around, so let's say they take, a good example of this is going to the grocery store and not being able to find things when things have not been moved. If a person gets lost in the car driving, even one time, their chance of getting in a very serious accident or getting irreparably lost is much higher. So you want to make sure that if that happens, remember, first of all, it's probably happened before now and you just weren't aware of it. And number two, you really want to protect your loved one from being in an accident that causes the death or harm to someone else as well as them. Some families I know noticed that their loved one was no longer bathing on a regular basis, and while they had never really had a smell before, they were starting to have an odor. Did you know that dementia affects your olfactory senses? That's right. So when someone has dementia, a lot of times they're no longer able to smell, which means they are not smelling themselves. And again, let's go back to food. They may not notice that food is old. It's a natural protection that our bodies give us to alert us when something's wrong. So when our nose doesn't work, we may eat food that's gone bad, and we definitely won't know if we smell bad or if our house smells bad. While this can also be a sign of getting older, it is often part of dementia. And finally, I will say that you need to trust your gut. If something is telling you that something's off and that your loved one is starting to have problems, I promise you there is more often than not more happening behind the scenes that you're not aware of. People that have dementia are great at hiding it. They're wonderful at having the same conversations every weekend with you about, I'm doing great. How are the kids? How's the weather? So don't feel bad if you haven't really noticed it up until now, but it probably has been going on for a while. The most important thing is to get educated and find out what you need to do to protect your loved one. There's some great books out there. There's a great book called Learning to Speak Alzheimer's, which I think is wonderful because you can kind of pick it up and just read a little bit of it and learn a lot. ALZ.org is the website for the Alzheimer's Association, and no matter what kind of dementia your loved one has, there's a lot of great information on how to take care of someone or love someone who has dementia of any type. The 36-Hour Day is a book that a lot of people really love. It's not my favorite, but that's okay. There are also a lot of great caregiver handbook type books out there, so definitely check it out. I also would recommend that you check out the 5 Wishes video that I've got. I will link it below in the description box. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do. You'll be notified when I upload new videos, and it helps more people see the videos. I want to help as many people as I can, and that is how we do it together. Thank you so much, and have a great day. Bye-bye.